Hey guys, Kim here with Art Classes for Kids. If it's your very first time to my YouTube channel, well, welcome. And if you've been here before, welcome back. Good to see you. Now, today we are going to be making a clay project. And this is one of our individual boxes that we sell right here for this project. This is the clay project inspired by the Tim Burton character, Beetlejuice. If you don't have a box, you can still make this if you happen to have some model magic around, which is the clay that we'll be using in this project. So if you do have a box, then I want you to get your box and we're gonna open it up, check out all the materials that you're gonna need. But before we get started, I just wanna let you know that I'm so glad you're here at my YouTube channel. And if you want to look all around, I've got all kinds of projects and you can learn all kinds of stuff from our channel. Now, I need you to subscribe so you don't miss out on anything. And at the end of this video, if you really enjoyed it, give me a like. But right now, let's take a look at this little character we're going to make. It's inspired by the movie character, Beetlejuice, that looks a little bit like this. You see? Now, Beetlejuice is a character that's like a ghost or like a spirit. And he's played by a human in the movie, but we're gonna make him look a little bit crazy and cartoony in our little sculpture. So let's get started. First of all, I want you to grab the box, open it up, and pull out the supply bag. And set your box aside. Now, we've got the instructions right here. This is for people that would like to just make art with instructions and not the video. If you bought the box and don't have time to watch the video, you might just want to dig right in and read the instructions. Or you can join us like you have on this video and make sure you have all the supplies that are needed. You will be getting one foam board base. It has a label on the back. You're going to set that here. You've got 1 ounce packets of Model Magic. You've got two of the white, you've got one of the blue, and you've got one of the yellow. I'm gonna set it all up here. Next, you're going to need a pencil, a black Sharpie, and two of these sandwich picks. They're a little bit bigger than a toothpick. And if you're making this at home and you don't have a sandwich pick, you can use toothpicks in place. Okay, take a look from our overhead view. You can see all that we have for this project. And then once you've gathered up everything you need, let's get started. Alrighty, pushing everything aside, the first thing I'm going to do is put my name and today's date on the label on the back. Now, a lot of times I really like all my students to always have the date because, you know, not only are you making this cool little character sculpture, but this might be part of your holiday decor. Like maybe you're already decorating for Halloween and maybe you're gonna put this in a closet and bring it out every year for decoration. Or maybe you're just gonna leave it out all year long, but maybe 10 years from now you're gonna wonder, hey, how old was I when I made that? And you're gonna do the math by looking at the date you made it. So we're gonna set that aside. Next, we're going to need, oh, one more thing that you're going to need from your house. You probably have a pair of scissors around. Grab the scissors, you're gonna need it to cut things open. So we're gonna start with white Model Magic. Open up this packet. If it's your first time ever using Model Magic, just flip it over and there's a seam. Pull across the seam to open it up. You're gonna take this whole piece out. You're gonna press, 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 and get all the clay out that's stuck to the packaging and set that scrap aside. Next, you see it comes in a little block. We're only going to be using, oh, let's say half of this. So cut it in half. We're gonna be using half of the white block to start. Now, what we're gonna be doing is we're gonna start building up the bottom part of our sculpture, which is a tombstone. So now Beetlejuice is a spirit, like a ghost, and we're gonna place him around where dead people are in the graveyard. But what we're gonna do is knead our clay to get it warmed up. So if you've never kneaded clay before, what you do is you're gonna warm it up in the palms of your hands, or you're gonna smash it and stretch it. But the goal is to get it smooth and warm. It's better to use your hands than roll it on the table because your hands are warmer than the table. Now we've got our nice, smooth ball, but we wanna add color to it. So we wanna make it kind of a light blue. So we're gonna open up our blue. And we're gonna take a pinch, just a little pinch of clay. Look at how tiny that is. Just like the center of a bagel, if this was a bagel. And then you're gonna rip it and stack it, and you're going to knead it some more. So now all these blue stripes are going to keep mixing until it's one solid color. So I just keep it going. And before you know it, see, I just stretch it, stack it, stretch it, stack it. Now I think I'll roll it in a ball. So I'll just kind of mix it all up. Roll it in a ball. And let's try it one more time. Now, if I wanted to look like a gray blue, look kind of like dirtier blue than this, then what I'm going to do is smash it, stretch it, and add a little bit of black coloring to it with my black Sharpie marker. So I'm going to get it dirty with this by drawing all over it. And I'm going to stack it in half, draw on it some more, and do that one more time. Stretch it, get some more black on it, and stack it. Okay, now we're just going to knead this all together, and this blue will be a little bit grayer blue when we're done kneading it. Now, while I'm working on this project and you're watching this video, I'm gonna be moving pretty fast. So if I'm moving too fast for you, pause it at any time and then press it to play again when you're ready to continue. Okay, so I have this gray or blue and I'm going to smash it. But I'm going to take my base and smash it with that because that gives it a nice smooth finish. Okay, I wanna make the shape of a tombstone is usually the sides are straight and the top is either curved. The bottom part is usually straight. So I'm making like three sides of a box. And I'm leaving the top to just be kind of free form or curved. So now I've got my tombstone. I don't want it too thin because I don't want it to be floppy. Now we can decorate that a little bit. So take your pencil and you'll be able to see that I'm just gonna draw maybe a skull, something kind of deadly, and some eyes, some nose, and mouth. Maybe I'm gonna put some little flowers, like some roses around it. I don't know, just some kind of design. And then I'm going to say R, I, P. For rest in peace. So this is going to be my tombstone. This is going to go on my base for now and right down there, and I'm just gonna let it start to dry. So try to balance that, set that right there. And now we're gonna get to our Beetlejuice. So I'm taking the other half that I have and I'm going to cut it in half. And I'm gonna cut it in half and I'm going to roll this into a ball. And this is going to be Beetlejuice's head. I set it down and now I'm going to roll the second part into a ball. And I've got two balls. One's gonna be the head, one's gonna be the middle of the jacket. Okay, or the front and stuff. So now I'm gonna borrow this again, and I'm going to press this down. Whoops, put it on this side. Like I did before on the other one. I'm going to press it into a triangle shape. So now I have a flat-ish triangle. and I'm gonna press it and make it bigger. So now I have this triangle shape. I can press it with my hands if I want. And I'm going to stick it into the head. But what I really want to do is make sure it stays good. So I'm taking one of my picks and I'm going to break it or cut it with the scissors in half and stick it into the jacket and then into the head. Now it's going to be stronger. Okay, so we've got this jacket. I'm going to round the jacket at the bottom a little, or curve it in. So you see in my overhead view, I've got the head, I've got the jacket, and now it looks like we need a little more white clay. So what we're going to do is open the second packet. And with the second packet, let's take the whole thing out. You're gonna break off two little sections like this. These are going to be the legs, but let's first make them into two balls like this. And then we're gonna do one more section and we're gonna roll this into one ball and we're gonna cut this ball in half and have two parts, two half balls equal the arms. Now we're gonna put those parts together. So for the arms, we're gonna roll it into a coil, or what I call a carrot shape, once one end's a little skinnier than the other. One end's flat, one end skinny, like that. Now let's do that again, roll it. So one end is fat. It's like kind of like a cone, except I call it like a carrot shape because it's long. Now we're gonna hook those in between the head and the top of the jacket, like that, like a stick man. And now each of these, we're also gonna roll into the shape of a carrot, but these ones are a little bigger. Let's make sure they're the same size. Yep, where do you think these go? You probably guessed right. Right under the jacket, like that. So press them down. Now we're going to position them. So you see how Beetlejuice is kind of crazy. He's like, hey, like that. We gotta get his arms bent and hands up. So I'm gonna bend and create an elbow, put the hand up, and then I'm going to flatten the tip of this because that's the end of the jacket. You can stretch it out and make it longer if you want. And let's hook it up to the head. Okay, you can use this pick as a tool too. So I'm stretching this arm out a little, and then this one's gonna be up a little higher, and I'm gonna push in the end of the jacket to the arm, and I'm gonna push this in a little, and so far it looks like a stick man, like this. Alrighty, next, these are the pants. So he's gonna be bending his legs, because he's gonna be sitting on top of the tombstone. So we're gonna make his left leg go to the side, and then bend the knee down. Like this. And on this side, we're not gonna go all the way to the side. We're gonna just bend it a little in. Looks like a little baby, like this. Now I take my pick and I pull the jacket down to the legs and make sure it's a little straighter, kind of like that. And now I'm going to make some simple shoes. You see these little shoes? You're gonna bend at the very bottom to make a little boot, and you can take your pick and press it to shape it. And this one I'm gonna bend over here. So it looks kinda like this. All right, now it's time to start drawing the clothes. Okay. We're gonna take our black Sharpie and we're going to draw. We're going to make little boots that go across here. So make a little line across the bottom. Make a line at the end of the jacket sleeve. And you can take these all the way around. Let's see where it goes. So you can pick this up, just don't squeeze it too tight because you don't want to change the shape. Okay, so now we have that, and we've got, oh, the sleeves. If you do bend it, just put it back where it was before, like put it back in position. Okay, so now we're going to start drawing the clothes. You see he has a striped outfit, he's got a tie, a white shirt, and everything is striped. So watch this. We start out with a diamond shape just under his head. Draw that diamond shape. Next, you're gonna draw a long diamond shape like this. So two diamond shapes touching, and it looks like that. Now fill in these shapes with black. And it'll look like this. Remember, pause anytime you need more time. Now, at the bottom of the tie, it looks like a V. We're gonna continue that V all the way to this up and to the side of the head. So it looks like this. And we're gonna take that line all the way around the back of the head. That is the edge of his jacket. So it should look like this. It looks like a sweater right now, but it's gonna become a jacket. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna start making another V that goes halfway up, like that. After you go halfway up, you're gonna go in a little, not all the way to the other line, and then back out. Then you're going over, up and over the shoulder, up and over the shoulder on the other side. That's what we call the lapels of a jacket. Now you're gonna take that around and to the back until it connects to the front, like that. Now we need to split the jacket in the front. So we're gonna go down towards the legs and have two lines that open up as they get down to the bottom of the pants. Then they're gonna be higher than or lower than the legs. They're going to go around and around because the suit jacket is longer than the top of the pants. So we have it look like this. Now we're gonna continue that line all the way around to the back. So I go to the side, and I take it all the way across and around to the back. And now you've got the whole jacket drawn, but now we need to add the stripes. Now the stripes are one stripe space apart. So that means the negative space is even with the positive space, meaning on here he's got the purple look of his jacket, and then it goes purple, white. We're doing the black and white version of his jacket. And we are going to start right next to the opening of his jacket at the bottom. We're gonna put a space and two lines, maybe three, depends on how skinny you draw your lines, on each side, like that. Now we're gonna continue doing that. I move a little to the right on the right side, and a little to the left on the left side. And then I go to the side of his body. And now I'm going to do the lapels, but those we're gonna go across, you see? Across like that. So now I'm going sideways and across. And you make them just as thick as the space between them. So we have it look like that in the front. And next we'll do the sleeves. The stripes are gonna go around the arm. So we're going to start at the wrist. Let's just do the front. So I've got one side like this, and now I'm doing the other. then I'm going to flip it over and continue it. Or do make it go over to the side where you can see where the stripe continues. Do that on both sides. And then flip it over. Or bend it so you can see it. And then do that to both sides. Alrighty, and now all we have left is the back of the jacket. The back of the jacket's pretty easy. You're just gonna go straight down with your stripes, and then do one on the side if you have space. You can do some on the back collar if you want. And that's how it looks. Now it's time to do the pants. The pants are gonna go vertical or follow the shape of the leg. So I'm gonna start in the middle of the front, and if my leg bends, my stripe bends. Here and down. Now I'm going to the other side. Now, if you accidentally get your stripes too close, you could always do a little surgery. That's where you open it up and you can cut away some of the black. Then flip it over. Okay, we've got our whole outfit drawn. Now we're going to fill in the shoes black. And flip it around and color the shoes black on the other side. And now we've got our whole outfit colored in, and now it's time to get to the face. You ready? Okay. Next, what we're going to do, let's see. We're going to take the pencil, and with the pencil, we're going to, pretty close to the tie, we're going to make a mouth, and he has kind of a smirk on his face. So you might want to have it a smile that's up higher on one side. So now what we're doing is we're going to make the nose. We're going to pinch it together, use our little pick, and push this up, the bottom of the nose up, and then if you want, you can poke two little nostrils in it. And now we're going to make some light blue with our extra clay. We're going to make the eyes, and after that, the hands. So take a piece, just a chunk of white, and add a tiny pinch of blue. And you're going to knead the blue with the white. And when you do that, you're gonna get a light blue, similar to what you had for the tombstone. So I just keep mixing it until I have a solid color of light blue. So I keep mixing, and pretty soon all of the stripes are gone out of the color mixture, and I roll it in a ball. I'm going to take a little pinch of this to make the tiniest little two blue circles, and I gotta make sure they're the same size. So I put them right next to each other, and if they are, and they're looking pretty good, I'm going to use my pick as a tool, pick it up, and press it right where the eye position is. Right there. Now make sure it's at least one eye space apart. You need them far enough away that you can draw black outlines around Beetlejuice's eyes. So now what we're going to do is take our black marker and put a black dot inside that hole. Then we're going to go around the eye one or two times. It depends on how thick you want his black outline, because you see, he has a lot of dark circles around his eyes. We're making the cutesy cartoon version though, so we can exaggerate. Okay,
And it looks, let me balance it out. I got it a little thicker on the bottom, so I'm gonna do that to both eyes. And fix my blue. There we go. Alrighty. So now, if we wanna have a little bit of a chin, we're going to push the face together a little and put the pick underneath the chin and pull it out a little. There we go. Now, we're gonna press the forehead down a little and we're going to take our pencil and draw two wrinkle lines above his eyes. Just like that. And squish his head back into place. Make sure we've got a little chin sticking out. And he's looking pretty creepy. Okay, now we're going to make two hands out of some of this blue scrap clay. And we're going to make two balls about the size of a pea. Now these are light blue balls about the size of a pea. They need to be the same size. This one looks a little bigger. And once you get these two balls, you're going to smash those and stick them at the end of his suit jacket where the cuffs are. So it looks like he has two little mittens so far, but what we're gonna do is take our scissors and cut one, two, three, four little cuts, just like this. You see, four little cuts in his hand. Then you can pull the fingers out if you want them longer, or you can keep them short. And you can decide if you want to pose the fingers or just keep them flat. That's all up to you. So I'm going to do the other hand as well. One, two, three, four. And now we've got that. We've got our crazy hands. Hands up. Now all that's left now is that crazy iconic green kind of spiky hair. Now this is when we use the yellow. We're gonna create a super light green. And we don't need that much. So when you open this up, cut off a chunk, maybe a quarter of this chunk, about this big. And we're going to add some blue to it. Only add a pinch of it at first because you don't want it too dark. Maybe that's even too much. I'm gonna take some out and I'm going to add more later if I don't think my green's dark enough, because really, what I can do is I can make it darker, but I can't make it lighter afterwards. So I'm going to need this. And I'm getting a light green. Okay, let's make it a little darker. We're gonna add some more blue. And so I keep mixing, I'm stretching, I'm stacking, I'm mixing it all up. And while I'm mixing this, we haven't even really talked about the movie. So this character is one of the main characters of the movie Beetlejuice, which was made about 35 years ago. And then a new version came out called Beetlejuice, Beetlejuice, because it's a sequel, the second version. And I don't know if you know this, but for Beetlejuice to appear in his character form in the movie, they gotta say Beetlejuice three times, and then all of a sudden his spirit appears. Now, Beetlejuice is a spirit that, you know, kind of haunts the house, but it's trying to help the people who used to live there get rid of the people who currently live there. And that's what the whole plot to the story basically is. He's also a shapeshifter, if you know what that is. That means he can change his form. And he turns into this snake that you see behind me. So now we're gonna get back to this hair. I've got some green. Now with the green, I'm gonna roll it into the skinniest worm. That's not even skinny enough. It needs to be like almost as skinny as thread. I'm going to roll these as quick as I can. You're going to make at least 10 of these. And these are going to become the hair for Beetlejuice. So I get a bunch of pieces, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to roll them and turn them into crisscross stars. So I take one of these pieces and I crisscross it three times. Then I take my pick, I stick it on the pick, it looks like a little palm tree. And then I roll it down and I stick it on his head. And now we do that a whole bunch of times and it becomes a crazy green hairdo. So I gotta stick this together, I gotta poke it, make my little tree, and stick it on. Let's see how quick I can do this. But remember, you at home, You take your time. You can take as long as you want. You just pause that video and join us when you've done the step and you're ready to join again. Okay, you can do them one at a time, or you can just make all the stars, then stick all the stars on. Let's see. There we go. Do I have any students that want to help me make stars? Lily's around. Okay, so I've got stars, stars, stars. Here you go, make some stars. Okay. Okay, I have lots of stars. See all my stars? Now I'm going to pick them up, curve them down, and stick them on my hairdo. Boom. You can just lay this guy on his front side. Just don't smash his face. Okay, so you see how I'm just getting these all over his hair? Then I'm gonna go to the front. Put a few on there. Keep bringing them on. Okay, here's one. Okay, there's one. Let's put that one at the back and the bottom. I'm filling in little bald spots. If you want to do that, you can do those with little single ones. And I think he's looking pretty good now. He's got a pretty good head of hair now. Now what we're going to do is we're going to take this pick, and we're going to stick this pick all through his body so that we have a little support. Then we're going to stick this pick into the top of the tombstone like this. So now he's sitting on the tombstone. We can fix his expression if we want it a little more joyful, whatever we want to do, and then we're going to take and we're going to poke into our base with our pencil like two little dots. Put the other half of the sandwich pick there, and now we're going to put our tombstone into that pick. Stick it on there, and we're going to see if we can get it to balance. And remember, this takes about a day to completely dry. You just want to pose it into position and turn it around, take a look at it, and say, ooh, do I like how it looks, or do I need to adjust anything? Well, I'm adjusting the tombstone to cover the stick, and I kind of stretched out his jacket a little, so I'm gonna touch it up with my Sharpie, or you can wait until it's completely dry, and then the Sharpie draws on it even smoother. And now we've got our crazy Beetlejuice character. And we turn him around. He's sitting on his tombstone. I'm gonna have one leg out to the side. I'm reposing mine, but let me turn him around for you. So I'm taking mine and I'm sticking this leg up a little higher and putting that leg lower. And when I'm all done, ta-da! This is how our little Beetlejuice clay sculpture has turned out. I hope you enjoyed making this project, and if you did, give me a thumbs up, okay? And until I see you next, check out our website for all the different art boxes we have, and we'll keep making cool art.